Yeah.
We did that last week and it's crazy.
Oh, no, eh? Holly up to tread?
Oh, it's crazy. At the top it was a little hectic, but we did it.
Rob
and Yuri.
Yuri.
Nadine. Yeah. This is the famous guy we're telling you about. This is the famous guy we're telling you about. This is the famous guy we're telling you about.
Oh, yeah, guys. So this is like group number 4 that now knows me. Cool. Say hi to some fans.
Cheers, man.
Robert,
keep it up.
Nadine, and sorry again.
Yuri.
And Yuri.
Enjoy.
Now they're going to see themselves online. Nice. Well, hey, guys. Welcome to the Fonzdot blog. I'm here at Highwood Meadows. This is the Grizzly up here. I was here about a year ago with Steven and Brett, Frank, and we did Twit, which is pretty fun. Brett is now visiting here from Toronto. Him and Steven started at Pocaterra, way down at Little Highwood Pass. I parked over here, and I'm going to go surprise them by meeting him on Pocaterra Ridge. And we're going to do a little bit of exploring today. We're heading back towards Grizzly Coal, into the Larches. But look at this, snow! Right, so I broke out of the first section of trees. It does split in there a lot. Right now there's two paths, stick to the right one. It's a lot more mellow. This is the glory. Grizzly Peak, Grizzly Coal's around the corner. That's the edge of Twit. That's the ridge to the crazy Pocaterra. Everyone scrambles, and then this guy here, the easy soft guy in the back, that's Pocaterra Ridge. Well, here we go. I'm literally touching my first color changing larch ever. 30 years of mountains, I've never actually got to walk beside one of these while they're changing. I've seen them in the distance. So cool. So, if you don't know what a larch is, it's like a needle tree, a pine tree, spruce tree kind of style thing, but main difference is their branches are extremely bendy, as you can see. Ooh. And their needles change colors like a leaf, and they fall off. So isn't that just weird? But the colors I'm seeing here are not that epic. They get crazy red and orange sometimes. They're just pretty yellow in here, so pretty cool. Nookshook, Grizzly Coal, that way. That's the window, probably can't see it. That's Twit up there. So, if you want to head up Grizzly Peak, Grizzly Coal, Twit, or the craziest ridge walk in the area to the unnamed Pocaterra Peak, that's where you want to turn. Me, I'm heading up Pocaterra Ridge, this easy hill. That's a little Highwood Pass, right there. Pretty epic, eh? We're at the first peak here. Pretty good view. I didn't realize it's actually like fun on this side. I thought it was just gonna be baby crap. I'm assuming Brett and Steven have not even made it on top of this one yet, so I guess I got a little more trail running to do. Hell yeah. Cool. I got a fucking ridge walk. Woo! Well, let's have some fun. Ugly. I don't know if I'm in the shape to be doing this right now. Thank you. beauty shot of Elbow Lake back there. Tombstone's just around the corner. It's Tombstone Mountain. We got Ray. Pretty cool area. Definitely my favorite spot in the winter. It's usually about this time of day when I'm realizing that I shouldn't have left my trail runners in the car and I should have just retired these a day early. Okay, cool. Large patch number two. Definitely made this hike worthwhile. Alright, so maybe the ice trackers are better than micro spikes for stuff like this, because if I didn't leave them in my car, they're actually not bad on this shitty, kind of half-frozen, soupy mud shit. You're doing awesome.
We're good. Look at this little boy.
Heard you calling a dog. I'm like assuming this big guy. Is this little thing coming out of the corner?
This is my little thing.
Shit. What side do you start on? He
was trying to cross back that way.
What time?
9:30.
Yeah, 9:30. Oh shit. What time do you start? One.
Yeah.
So I'm actually coming down the other side. I bumped into Leslie, believe it or not, so that's funny. Today's the day of bumping into everyone on my Facebook that I don't know, which is probably 90% of the people. Woo! All right, so we have zero Brett and we have zero Steven, so I don't know what the deal is. We're basically off this. So, I'm thinking I'm just gonna hitchhike back. I'm not going through this whole thing again if they're not here.
Home again! I'm gonna fall! And then she talked to me. She
said, I'm like, gotta move on. I 100% gave up on finding these guys today. I was planning on hitchhiking back to my car. Look at this. You guys are within like a kilometer of your car.
We made it so close.
Steven.
Buddy, good to see you.
I can't believe I found you, man.
Yeah, it took us a half an hour to find the trail.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we were like... Yeah, it did, yeah, because we left the car just after 12, and then it was 12:30 when we got out.
Oh, I wasn't that far behind you? I started at 12:45.
Oh.
Yeah. This is it! That's what we're doing. Let's take a look at the old GPS. See what she says. Don't forget to keep going. Oh, it didn't fucking register. It didn't register. It didn't turn on. It's on, but it's not tracking me. Garmin! So, I just did the Pocaterra Ridge in 3 hours. You got you out of the mountains, man. Got you out of the fucking mountains. High five, new friends. Woo! Yeah! High five, we did it! Woo! Woo! Leslie! Fonzdot out.